Hello guys, welcome back to another reaction video here on Our Eyes, Your Eyes. I'm ready to watch episode 21 of Vinland Saga. But before starting this video, I just want to remind you to subscribe to the channel, click on the notification bell, and follow me in this adventure regarding Vinland Saga. Okay, let's see what's going to happen now, because they want to kill the king, and let's see if they can do it, how it will last, etc, etc, etc. I think I'm ready. Are you ready? It's time to watch it. Oh, we saw this person before. Ah, okay. Come on, Ashelado, tell us. No. Oh, oh, oh. No. Oh, no. It's all orchestrated, right? I mean, it's all planned, right? No! No! Eva! Oh, oh, oh! I remember him! No! Not at all. Yeah, but why that surname? I mean. Yes. Oh my God, Leif! No, Knuto. It's an impostor. It's a woman. No! Especially one. Oh yes, absolutely. Nice question. That's exaggerated. No, it's impossible. He is blind right now. I mean, he is blind because the only thing he sees is the revenge. Yeah. Ah, he has a good mind. Of course. Lots of experience. Exactly. Yes. Is he going to spread the things? Okay, I thought the same. Yeah. Good job, Aselardo! So great! Yeah, actually, yes, he's unbelievable. Me too! Can't wait! Again! Ah! Right. Eh? What? Why? Ah, maybe I understand. Okay. I don't think he hates you. Do you remember what I told you? Yes. His friend. I think you were. Somehow. I can't believe this. Wow, this is hard. I told you in the previous episode. Yeah. I think this episode is full of feelings, different feelings, mixed feelings. So I'm going step by step, as always, and we can analyze each point of this episode. I think it was really, really great, really emotional. I wanted to talk about Kanuto, Knuto, whatever, a few seconds, because later I'm going to develop some other things. He is so changed right now, and I can barely recognize Knuto, because he is totally the opposite. And I think even the king can believe that he's becoming something like that. It's such a fast changing that I can't still believe it. And when they were starting their plans, when they were trying to attack Knuto, I really thought that they attacked him so they could make me believe that as well as a viewer. It was really nice. I could believe, oh my god, right now Knuto is over. That was so easy, that was so fast. But at the beginning, yes, I thought it was Knuto. Then when I saw that he had the helmet, I understood it was a plan. It was strategically made as if Knuto was killed or was attacked. I have to say that Ashelad, Askeladd, whatever, he is so great. He has a strategical mind and he thinks all the tactics in order to reach his goal. So I think Knuto has to be grateful to have Ashelad, Askeladd, whatever, next to him. Otherwise, I think that Knuto, even in the previous episode, could have been killed. I think that even by having Thorfinn next to him is such a great move, because he helps Knuto in a sort of a way. He is surrounded by good fellows this time. Okay, I didn't see Torkel so much this time, so I can't say anything about him. Okay, Leif, I'm so happy to find him over there, because he promised till the end of my life I will find a way to reach Thorfinn again. That was his promise to Thorfinn's mom and to Thorfinn's sister. So I think he made it. Somehow he met Thorfinn again. But now it's so hard to convince him to come back. What I didn't like about Thorfinn somehow, but on the other side I still understand him, is that he doesn't care about his mother. He doesn't care about his sister. He doesn't care about the air conditions anymore, because now he's too focused. Right now he's so blind, and the only thing he sees is the revenge. He can't look here. He is just looking over here. But he's going to regret this, because if his mother is going to die before seeing him, I think he will regret this for the rest of his life. So I agree what Leif says, please go back home and find your mother, because right now her condition is worse. Instead of losing another dear person, try to repair. Try to stay near to your dear people until they are over there for you. That's really awesome what Leif said. But on the other side, I still understand when Thorfinn says, for you it's enough. But you don't know what I passed through, so you can't judge me. You can't understand what I'm doing this. Because they took away a person, the dearest person of my life. And it's impossible to forgive. It's impossible to forget what happened. I don't know what to choose this this time. Because usually I'm strict. I mean, I know what I choose. But here, the only thing I dislike, yeah, is that when Leif talks about his mother, he is answering, don't talk to me about people I didn't ask you. That was really rude, typical of the behavior he is following in all these years. I mean, for 11 years he was growing up surrounded by people like him right now, so he can't be different. He became a part of this team. He grew up by seeing what other people did. And he adjusted himself with this new behavior, even to protect himself. Probably he's doing this as putting a shield in front of him to protect his inner feelings. This happens so many times. Many people who suffer, they put like a shield or more than one shield in order to protect themselves from suffering again. So probably he didn't want to hear about his mother, because it's hard to talk about his mother. He knows he left, so he knows how painful it could have been for his mother to have left like that. He knows somehow that he is guilty by not asking or by leaving. In one of the previous episodes, when he was dreaming, Thor's, and he was on top of Thor's. And Thor's told him, remember Thorfinn, now you are handling the family because you are the male son, so you have to take care of your mother and your sister. And in his dream, he said, yes, of course. So I don't think he doesn't care at all, but I didn't like the answer because, look, I'm quite emotional regarding mothers, fathers, brothers and sisters, I mean family in general, so I would have not answered like that. His father was clear with him. He was totally right when he said, please stop, don't do this again, stop this revenge. But yeah, I was happy to see Leif still alive, and I hope that Thorfinn will understand and he comes back to Leif so he can come back home. Let's talk about Ashelad, Askeladd, whatever. Here we saw his humanity. I mean, if you remember in the previous episode when I saw that scene all alone, I felt as if Ashelad was always alone in his life. And probably he also regretted this, right? Do you remember? I was discussing about it. But now I understood from many gestures, from many things he did, that he was not considering himself alone. I mean, I deeply think that Bjorn was one of his best friends, but he couldn't say it. Ashelad is not the type of person who says things. He's doing things, he's making facts. When we saw that Ashelad wanted to visit Bjorn, just the fact that he visited Bjorn, it's a way of saying, I love you, you're like my brother, you're like my best friend. Or when Bjorn said, okay, see you next time. He's turning because he has to leave, but he is doing it in a sad way. Ah, do you really want that I leave? I mean, I know you're about to die. Is it okay for me to leave? Even in this case, I found him so human. I found that he was so sad his friend was about to die. Now, there was this final duel. I understood why Bjorn decided to be killed by Ashelad. One of the reasons could be, look, I love so much who you are. The fact that you have always been so strong, and I don't want to be killed by anybody else except for you. I understand that Bjorn wanted to respect the greatness of Ashelad, and he didn't want to be killed so easily by others. He preferred to be killed by his friend, because that was a sort of freedom. That was a sort of escape from pain. I was killed by him, because I was about to die anyway, so the best way to leave this earth is this. And when I told you in other episodes that Vikings didn't have this perception of feelings and stuff like that, here is totally the opposite. Even Vikings, they are humans and they feel something, but they are surrounded by this shield, like Thorfinn in this case, that they wanted to protect themselves because they are so in touch with violence, rudeness and whatever, so it's impossible for them to handle all this killing procedure by involving feelings. And finally, when Bjorn said, I wanted to be your friend, and when I said to you, I thought that Ashelad was already your friend, because of what I told you some minutes ago. Yes, it was really emotional, and fortunately and finally Ashelad said it this time. Instead of doing other stuff in order for other people to understand that he cares, no, in this case he said it, you were already my friend. That was amazing. I really loved this episode because, yes, as I told you, humanity, feelings are the protagonists here. Let's see what's going to happen in the next episode. Can't wait. Of course, can't wait to see the new plan. I mean, what's going to happen in the next day. But yeah, Thorfinn, come on. Even the fact that Ashelad next, he said, okay, Thorfinn, now it's your turn. I felt so sad. I think it was inappropriate to do a duel with Thorfinn right now. But this is another side of the personality of a Viking. He can erase the pain sooner after because he has something else to do. They don't want to show their feelings so easily. That's another point that they have in common, because even Thorfinn, in the case of his mother, he didn't want to show any pain. Ashelad, Askeladd, whatever, and Thorfinn, in my opinion, they are similar. They lived so much pain in their lives that now they are exorcising this pain in another way. Even if it's wrong, but they do it. And they are both the same. That's my opinion. Let's see in the other three episodes if I think something else or if I change my mind. But anyway, hope you enjoyed. Stay tuned because next Thursday I come back with episode 22. Oh my god, we are reaching the end. I can't believe it. The end of season 1, because when season 2 will come, it will be different. Okay, subscribe to the channel, click on the notification bell. Bye guys, see you in the next video. See ya!